your baby boy and give sight to a blind man.
Mary, did you know
that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hands?
Did you know that your baby boy has walked where
King of Israel. Oh,
brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. Oh, night divine, oh, night when Christ was born. When Christ was born, oh, night divine, oh, night divine, oh, night when Christ was born.
So I praise Jesus, I will give you praise.
The first candle of Advent is the candle of hope. We will light this first candle, a candle of hope in the midst of the painful stories of this year. Let it burn through these weeks as a beacon to become the light of hope. Let it guide us to Christ's presence in our midst, leading us to His peace, justice, and joy in the service of love. God, be with us in this light of hope. The second candle of Advent is the candle of peace. We will light this second candle, a candle offering comfort to weary spirits after a year of pain and loss. Let its glow remind us of Christ's tender care and warm our lives in the light of His peace. Let it guide us to Christ's presence in our midst, leading us to His peace, justice, and joy in the service of love. God, be with us in this light of peace. The third candle is the candle of joy. We will light this third candle and delight in the sparkle of its outrageous reminder to rejoice. Let its flame cast light into shadowy places and show where work is to be done. Let a community of faith be formed in the light of joy. Let joy find home in our hearts and make space for Christ's presence there as we work for justice and peace in the service of love. God, be with us in this light of joy.
Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Christ the Lord.
Thank you. Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 14. It says, "And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, 'Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger.' And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased.'"
Oh, the joy to be, joy to know it's when I decrease. You fill up my soul, what a joy to see. Joy to hold it's when you increase. I want nothing more. Open my hands, humble my heart, all that I have is yours. Color my prayers, widen my eyes, wash me in glorious light. Oh, the joy to be, joy to know it's when I
Our Almighty Father, we adore your name and glorify you forever. It is by your will that we are alive and healthy. We are here today to worship with you. Father, may you remind us that no matter what trials await us tomorrow, may we never forget the blessings you have shown us. Help us to cling to you as our anchor. Help us to remember your steadfast love and faithfulness for us in all things, because you are our hiding place, and under your wings we can always find refuge. May you protect us from any trouble and keep us away from evil. Father, I pray that may the good news of Jesus' arrival bring such joy to our world and reach those who are lost and searching with the message of hope that we have through the Messiah. Father God, allow your message of peace to bring comfort to our anxious world. And as we all go about the holiday season, let the message of great joy pierce through all the noise and into people's heart. We ask all these things in your mighty name, and in Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Scripture reading for today is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verses 1 to 5. Comfort, O comfort, my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. This is the word of the Lord.
Nothing in this world will do. Good evening, maayong gabi sa tanan. Welcome to our youth worship tonight. How are you these days? I know that we are all busy, especially for you students. Next week will be the schedule for your final exam. And to us, December will always be a busy month where we all have the occasions to celebrate, reunions, giving of gifts, and even Christmas fellowship. So I intend this meditation for tonight to speak about comfort. I know the way we celebrate Christmas today is quite different 2 years ago when we celebrate Christmas with so much fellowship. Now, because of the pandemic, our ways of doing Christmas is also changed. I know for a fact that most of us, we are also worried about our health. And for this Christmas, how can we celebrate Christmas? Do we still have reasons to celebrate Christmas? Now let me share to you the text from Prophet Isaiah. We all need this text, we all need this message, knowing that we need comfort, especially in this challenging time. Let me walk you through the text in Prophet Isaiah. The text in Prophet Isaiah is actually the usual text that we use during Advent season, where it talks about how do we prepare the way for the coming of the Lord. It also speaks about comfort and hope in the midst of difficult situation. It can be read as a prophetic response to the outcries of pain like those voiced in Lamentations. Now, to give you the background about this text was written by Prophet Isaiah by the time when there was so much destruction for the people. The Jerusalem temple was destroyed, and for the people of Israel, it was so painful. They are into a desperate move where they are in exile because they were captive by the Babylonians. And so, Prophet Isaiah speaks about promises, and he tried his best actually to convince the people to have hope, to believe in the words of God, that God is still working in them, that God is faithful to his promise. Well, we cannot question the Israelite people because of so much problem that they have, the challenges that they face. Isaiah find it very relevant to talk about comfort for those people who are in desperate situation. So this is a kind of preaching that is grounded in the proclamation and promise, but also shaped by the fundamental and careful listening of those things that afflict or influence the hearts of the people. So here, Isaiah talks about how to comfort the people and to give them hope that better days are coming. A comfort that will inspire them, speaking to them in tender ways. Now, I also like how Isaiah mentioned how to comfort people in this time. He mentioned about the ways to prepare the coming of the Lord. It's quite poetic when he mentioned that the valleys will be lifted, the mountains will be made low, and the uneven ground will be leveled. The rough places will be made plain. Now, we have been expecting, actually, that it should be the God who will prepare the way for his people so that the Israelite people could go back to their place. But here in this text is quite different. Instead of the people, instead of God preparing the ways for the people, here, it's the people who need to prepare the way for the Lord. Now, let me share to you one of my experiences. Last week, I was invited to visit one of the church member in Valencia. When we came there, of course, I was with my husband, Joshua. The member suggested that she would tour us to the geothermal plant in Valencia. And on our way there, I feel like I'm on the top of the world. The road is good. It is cemented, but it has so many curbs, actually. My eardrum started to tickle due to the pressure, signaling that we are really in a high altitude. Then, when we were on the top, we saw a community there. Actually, I didn't expect that there were people living in that place because it's too high. And then, that member also tried to explain that it's hard to go to the community before because the road was not good. They even tried to ask people to fix the road and even wrote a letter to Duterte. And now, the road is passable, making ways to the people who would like to visit and see the place. So why am I sharing this? Because road is essential. I like how Isaiah used the metaphor in preparing the coming of the Lord. It's like making roads. It's like making ways. Making ways is essential. It makes our journey exciting and easy. And sometimes it also humbles us, finding ways, asking for help, and at the same time, making ways to go there, efforts to go to the place. So Isaiah used this metaphor to explain of something. He spoke from an experience that needs comfort. He speaks from an experience where people lost their hopes. What they can do, what he can do as a prophet, is to provide the people a new way. It's to provide the people a new perspective in life, a new vision, a new hope that will give them reason to continue believing in God, to continue in their journey of faith. Isaiah tries his best to show them the way to restore and to recover themselves from all the traumas in life, making the Israelite understand that they need to continue the journey because God is with them. If it seems to be no road, then Isaiah said, "Let us make roads, let us make pathways. If it's too difficult, it will be made easy for us because the Lord is with us." Now, this message of Prophet Isaiah to the Israelites, I think it's also relevant to us today. We've been to a lot of traumas, so many deaths, many people lose their jobs and other opportunities. The restrictions and protocols because of this pandemic separate us from our loved ones. The online distance learning is overwhelming for the students. I think, just like the Israelites, we also need this time. We need and we are looking and longing for comfort and hope. With all these difficulties, how can we make our celebration meaningful and relevant? Are there still reasons to celebrate Christmas despite the traumas that we've been through, despite the difficulties and the challenges? Remember how Isaiah presented this message to the people who are suffering. I would like us to take the two key words in this text. The first key word is Isaiah mentioned about tender speaking, or how do we speak to each other? How do we comfort people? Of course, we need to speak tenderly to the people. In our text, the literal translation would be speak to the heart. The heart in that culture as it is in us today, our hearts represent the core of the person, the innermost being. If we are trying to comfort the person by speaking to his or her heart, then we must speak softly and tenderly. Now, as Christians, as community of faith, we are called to comfort. And we need to use words to speak tenderly to comfort other people. I must say that words are powerful, especially in our context. As Christians, we are stewards of words. In everything we say, in our conversation with other people, in our relationship and fellowship, we use words. May we use our words to pave the way for better relationship. May we use our words to pave way for better community and better society. I know the words can be expressed in many forms. It could be verbal or non-verbal or written. So whatever forms may use, we will use, make sure that our words brings comfort to other people. Now, here's the problem. In this time of social media, how do we use words? We are challenged these days to use our social media as a platform to proclaim the good news of comfort and hope to the people. It's so sad nowadays. We spread hate speech, and sometimes we belittle people, we bully people in the society through social media. So it's affecting our relationship, it's affecting our minds, it's affecting our hearts, and we should do something about it. If words are powerful, if speaking tenderly would bring comfort and hope to others, then we must use it the way God would want us to use our words. Speak about love, speak about comfort and hope, so that we can inspire people in this time of crisis. The second key word is making ways. Of course, this is a metaphor. To comfort people, we are called to journey with them. We are called to spend time with people and listen to them in their stories. So the journey, if we describe our life as a journey, it would be good if someone will journey with us, helping us to get through the road, helping us to make ways and be able to reach our destination. Now, I want this metaphor of road making ways and interpret it in a more communal way. For example, may we make ways to reconciliation and peace building. May we find courage and comfort in the ways of our community as we aspire to live in a peaceful, caring, and loving community. May we make ways in our journey with those who are lonely. We journey with them for those in need in our society. We make ways for the restoration of broken relationship, reconciliation of families and friends, and comfort those who are brokenhearted. For in these ways, we can all be made whole and ready to love and open our hearts. What I'm trying to say is that here, we serve as instrument, as the way to promote healing, to promote reconciliation. Mahimo unta ta nga instrument of peace and comfort and healing to those in need. Let ourselves be the road where people can journey with us and they could find peace with us. And as a community of faith, as Christians, we are called to bring that into an avenue where everybody will feel that they are loved and acceptance. We should provide new ways, new vessels, new opportunities, new vision, new roads and perspective in life so that others may still find reasons to celebrate Christmas this year. So my dear friends, so much more about comforting others by our words and making ourselves available as their way and instrument to reconciliation. Let us also not forget to comfort ourselves, because we cannot comfort others if we are not comforted individually. So let me ask you, how do you comfort yourselves these days? For you students, I know you are struggling and you are a little bit pressured because of the exam, but I do hope you will find time to comfort yourself. Comfort food, probably. Kind words to yourself. Appreciate yourselves. Affirm yourselves that you've done great things. You've done good and well in this life. So give yourself a pat on your back, telling yourself that you are loved, you are accepted, you are appreciated. We need those words. If Isaiah mentioned about these two things, how to comfort each other, our words, ourselves as instrument, as new ways to promote peace and reconciliation, good relationship with each other, then we must make time to have this too in us. May this will comfort us. May this will find reasons for us to celebrate Christmas despite the not so good stories that we've been through these years. So my dear friends, dear young people, it is my prayer that may we all find comfort in this season of Advent, that you may find comfort for yourself through the words of other people, even an appreciation of yourself. It is my prayer that we will find that these days. It is also our challenge to extend that comfort to others. May we find comfort in words. May we find comfort in our community and family. And may we find comfort in the promise of God's presence in us. So as we celebrate Christmas season, let us be comforted with these words. Amen.
Magnifies the Lord, my heart. Psalm 146, verse 10. The Lord reigns forever. Your God, O Zion, for all generations. Praise the Lord.
Let us pray. O Lord our God, we thank you for this time, and as we long for the fullness of Jesus' reign in us, we wait with joy in our hearts, knowing that you are faithful and true to your promise. We thank you for gathering us tonight, for meeting us and feeling you in our worship together. May you be praised by our songs. May you be touched by our commitment and thanksgiving. Thank you, O Lord, for this Spirit-filled experience with you and your people. Thank you for moving our hearts and spirits with the good news of comfort from the prophet Isaiah. Thank you for reminding us once again that we too can be instrument of your comfort to others in our words and the way we make ourselves we make time for others. Thank you for reminding us, O Lord, that we can still find comfort even in the midst of challenges. Lord, as you call us to be your people, help us to extend the comfort that we receive from you to others. And as we share the good news of your love and comfort to others, we join and pray for those people who need it. We pray for those who are sick. We pray for our students who are preparing themselves for the final exam. And we pray for those who are in need. Lord, we pray for healing. We pray for blessing and guidance as we continue our journey. Walk with us, O God. Guide and strengthen us and empower us to do good and share the good news of comfort and hope to others. Hear the prayers of your young people, dear God, even the unspoken concerns of our hearts. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. And now, children of God, may God, who has begun a good work within you, continue the work until the fullness of God's reign. May your love overflow more and more. May you continue to grow in knowledge and understanding. Be kind, be generous, be just, so that you will comfort other people. And may the Holy Spirit guide you in faithful living until Jesus comes. We go in peace to love and serve the Lord in the name of Christ. Amen.
Children weep no more, hope is on the horizon, weary world behold, your promised Messiah, angels let your soul
song began. Here over all who mourn. Breaks the dawn of salvation.